Welcome back to Rodder's Garage, everybody. Today, we're going to be back on the 58 Apache. Got to focus on the cab a little bit today. Get a bunch of holes in the firewall plugged up, some stuff smoothed out in the dashboard, and get the brake pedals and steering column back in this thing, as well as we're going to pull the small block out and fit a big block in it just to make sure we have clearance on the firewall. So I'm going to drop the gas tank, get a few things out of the way, clean the cab out, and then basically just go at it and start probably plug welding a bunch of those holes. Let's go at it.
Good.
So the column is mounted. So at this point, we can start installing the brakes and clutch pedal. Good.
Feels good.
Yeah, it looks right. Thank you. Good. Well, that pretty much wraps that up then. We can take all that stuff out. I'll have to finish welding it on the bench. Good. This is all going to be leaving tonight. As for the chassis, basically I have to get this Jeep done up on the hoist, and then we're going to end up putting the chassis up there and wrapping this up in the next video. I still have to do a couple clearance notches. One for this power steering line coming off the rack. We're just going to put a little notch in the front cross member going off to the back. I think I said it in the first video when we were doing the chassis the first time. I want to put two notches here and this 2x4 tube to give us a little more clearance for exhaust coming through. Obviously, we have to do C-notches for the axle yet to come in. When we do the C-notches, we're gonna box at least that section around the C-notch, give it a little extra strength there. We're also gonna have to box here where the frame was shortened, basically. This is kind of Z'd up here, where we shortened the frame from a long box to a short box way back in the beginning. And then we'll probably go ahead, come up here, put an angle on the back of this, blend this out, seal the backside of this plate for the crossmember for the transmission. Have to finish welding that up, and some boxing up here too. I'll probably box from the front of this plate right up to the front plates here for the suspension kit and just seal all these rails up in the front, mostly because there's a bunch of garbage in there yet from the first time they built it, all welded in pretty crazily, and I don't feel like having to cut all that stuff out of there. So we'll come back with a whole video on this, wrapping this up, sending it out the door. And that's gonna be about it for this time. Appreciate it, guys. Thanks for watching. Till next time.